story today about Fred and Florence. In 1971, they lived in Texas, and they received news that Florence's mother, who was in Hendersonville, North Carolina, was sick with cancer and wasn't expected to live. So they got in the car and drove from their little town in Texas all the way over to North Carolina and spent some time with Florence's mother, and then drove back home. This is 71, and did it again a few weeks later. And David decided that I will leave the car with Florence in North Carolina, and I'll take the bus back home, and I'll come back and forth by bus so that she has transportation while she's there. Well, the bus trip home was 40-some hours long, and after 40-some hours in the bus, he decided he didn't want to have to do that again, that there was no way to get back. So he thought, well, maybe I'll hitchhike. But then a friend, Henry, said, I have a little Cessna 180. And I would like to travel out that way, fly out that way, do a little bit of sightseeing. You can come with me. And so they did that on one particular day. They got into the Cessna 180, and the skies were sunny. He had his maps, and he took off. It wasn't long until they reached Houston, and the fog started to enclose them. And David, who had not been in a Cessna 180 before, and I don't know that I have, but it's a little plane, started to...
Horses.
Okay, and started to get a little nervous because they couldn't see. But Henry said, no problem. We have maps here. And you see over there those radio towers. We can keep that as our landmark, the radio towers of Houston. And with our maps, we'll make it to where we're going just fine. And so they did that. They got out of Texas and got close to Jackson, Mississippi. And the fog was really thick now. And David was really getting worried. But again, Henry said, we have our maps. And I can tell by our maps where the airport is, where the landing strip is. In fact, it should be right below us now. And he dropped down, and there was a little split in the fog. And sure enough, there was the landing strip, and they made land. But I should tell you, prior to that, the radio went out, and the instruments went out. I forgot to give you that little detail before they got to the Mississippi airport. And so they had no radio communication with the air tower, but according to their maps, they dropped down, and sure enough, they were right where they were supposed to be. Well, Henry found a repairman and got the radio fixed and the instrument panel fixed, gas or fuel in the tanks, and they took off. And pretty soon the skies were sunny, and David was beginning to enjoy his flight. He could see things down below that he hadn't seen before, and he began to relax till they got to Greenville, South Carolina. And by the time they got there, the fog was coming back in and was enclosing their little Cessna again. They were able to make it over one mountain range, and now they're into North Carolina, and the fog is really thick now. And they almost had a little incident, but they saw the trees in time and pulled up. But Henry decided that he needed to radio to the Asheville airport and ask for landing there. And so he did. And the controller there said, I'm sorry, our field is closed because of the fog. You can't get in. I advise you to turn around and go back to Greenville. But I can't go back, Henry said. I don't have enough fuel. I have to land now. And the controller, there was silence. And then the controller said, okay, I'll get the ground crew ready. Plan on an emergency landing. And so that's what Henry planned on. He had his maps. Even though he couldn't see anything, he told David, don't worry, we have our maps. And right below us should be the runway. And so he started to drive. There was a little bridge in the fog. Of course, the closer he got, the fog thicker. But it was a highway they were over, and he raised the nose and got up out of there just in time because there was a bridge that he was coming up on. And They were desperate. They didn't know what to do because their maps, they seemed to be off. The pilots were off from their maps. And they, you know, they were Christian people and they were praying. And soon they heard a voice. A composed controller's voice said, "If you will listen to me, I will help you get down." And Henry said, "Yes, please help us." And he said, "You need to come down some. You're a little high. So come down a bit and over to the right." And so Henry did that. And the controller then said, "Okay, I want you to ease up. You're going a little bit too fast. Ease up just some. And you need to raise it up just a bit." And Henry did that and kept on going. And then the controller said, "You're still too far left. Come over to the right." And Henry did that. And then they kept going with silence. And David's thinking, "This is taking forever." Then the controller's voice came back on and said, "You are over the runway. I want you to drop now. And do it now." And the pilot did it then. Came through the the fog, saw the lights on the runway, and was touched down. And when they taxied to the end and stopped, they both, before they did anything else, prayed to God for the safe deliverance and the safe landing. Then Henry got back on the radio and said, "Thank you so much for helping us, because we could never have done it. We would have lost our lives." And the controller said, "What do you mean? The last time I spoke to you and heard from you is when I told you to turn around and go back to Greenville. I haven't talked to you. I haven't heard from you. And when you dropped down, it was all of a sudden we saw your plane on the landing strip. We had nothing to do with that." And I'm telling you this story because an angel, God somehow, through his angel or whatever he did this, he got those two men safely on the ground. And listen, whether we're young or old, that we're lost in a fog sometimes. Mm-hmm. We may be going home in the snow today. But whatever it is, we can depend on our Heavenly Father to guide us safely through. It doesn't matter, even if we don't have physical maps to get our way around, we've got God's Word and His promises, and they are as sure as God Himself. And so we have a heavenly guide that will get us safely through all the fog and the storms and the trials and the temptations we might be faced with if we will just turn to Him. Thank you.